हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंत फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 62। Redmi's first foray in gaming phones is here, and it is called the Redmi K40 Gaming Edition. The K40 Gaming Edition covers all the bases considered a serious gaming smartphone. You have a 120Hz display with 40Hz touch sampling rate, and a physical shoulder triggers to enhance control, and a 5000mAh battery that can go all day and charge in 42 minutes with supply at 67W charging. The Redmi K40 Gaming Edition uses a 6nm Dimensity 1200 chipset, paired with 6GB, 8GB and 12GB of RAM storage options, such as 6GB 128GB storage and 8GB RAM 128GB storage, 8GB 256GB storage, 12GB 128GB storage and 12GB RAM and 256GB storage. Cooling is achieved through a combination of graphene, graphite and a vapor chamber. There are no built-in fans nor a fan accessory here. Visuals are handled by 6.67 inch AMOLED panel with a 120Hz refresh rate. Triple camera is flankled by accent lightning and the LED flash shaped like Velle flash. You get a 64 megapixel main camera, 8 megapixel ultra wide unit and a 2 megapixel macro camera. Sound was delivered by JBL tuned stereo speakers and on the top and bottom of the Redmi K40 Gaming Edition. Additionally, you get high resolution audio and a Dolby Atmos support. Vivo V21 5G and Vivo V21e has been launched in Malaysia. Key specifications include an AMOLED display, 44 megapixel selfie camera and a 33W fast charging. Vivo V21 5G India launch is set for April 29th. IQ has launched its latest flagship 5G smartphone, the IQ 7 and IQ 7 Legend in India. As they promised, both have a 6.62 inch Full HD Plus AMOLED screen with a 120Hz refresh rate. And we can also see it as a 91.4% screen to body ratio, and IQ 7 runs on Snapdragon 870 processor, while IQ 7 Legend Edition runs on the latest Snapdragon 888 processor with up to 12GB of enhanced LPDDR5 RAM and 256GB of storage. And it works on FunTouch OS 11.1 based on Android 11. India's smartphone shipments registered a record of 23% year-over-year growth to hit 38 million units in the first quarter of 2021. According to the latest report from Counterpoint's Market Monitor, the growth was mainly driven by new product launches, promotions, financial schemes and pent-up demand from 2020. Researchers, however, warn the growth in space could decline in the coming quarters due to the current wave of COVID-19 pandemic. Xiaomi led the market in quarter 1 2021 with a 26% shipment share. 5 out of the top 10 smartphones model in the country were from Xiaomi. After Xiaomi, Samsung was in the second position with 20% share value, and Vivo, Realme and Oppo had 16%, 11% and 11% market shares respectively. Fire in a factory of Casitec Group, a Taiwanese-based electronic manufacturer which is also a supplier to technology giant Apple, near Shanghai in China has killed 8 people, including 2 firefighters. As per the statement from the government of Jinshan District related to the incident, the fire broke out at the factory on Thursday at 1:30 PM and raged until Friday morning, killing 2 firefighters and 6 civilians. The fire was fierce, that over 900 firefighters, 123 fire engines and 8 robots were deployed to fight the fire. Officials are still investigating how the fire started, but the flames quickly engulfed the large plant when it gathered momentum. Another user database has been leaked to the dark web, but this time the victim is popular online grocery delivery platform Big Basket. The massive data leak is said to comprise the data of 20 million Big Basket users, including their email ID, home address, phone number, IP address and more such personal data. The data leak from the company servers was first acknowledged by the service back in November last year. The hackers behind the leak has now published the user data on a cybercrime forum and has made it available for anyone to download. As per the threat intelligence SaaS provider Sabal, the cyber group has been active since 2015 and has been leaking the user database on a dark web from long. The group has leaked a combined total of 73.2 million user records from over 11 different companies till date. The third phase of the COVID-19 vaccination drive is set to begin on May 1st in India. The Indian government has announced that every citizen above the age of 18 will be eligible to get vaccinated in the third phase of the vaccination drive. The drive will begin from May 1st and the registration for which will begin from April 28th. Everyone who is above the age of 18 has to register themselves on the Cowin website or Arogya Setu app to schedule an appointment to receive the first shot of the vaccine. To register for the COVID-19 vaccine, follow these steps. Go to Cowin website using any browser. Click the register or sign in yourself to begin the self-registration process. The website will ask you to enter your phone number. For receiving an OTP, enter OTP you receive on your phone. The website will ask then for your details for a photo ID proof. Select the valid photo ID proof from the list like Aadhaar card, driving license, PAN card, passport, pension, passbook, NPR, smart card or voter ID. Enter the photo ID number, name, gender and year of birth. Once all the fields were filled, click on register. After registering, the website will let you schedule an appointment with your nearest vaccination center. You can also add 3 more members on the same account. Enter the PIN code in the search bar to select your nearest vaccination center and select the available time slot. Click confirm and you will have a scheduled vaccination appointment. You will receive a text message on the registered mobile number with the appointment details. The registration for the COVID-19 vaccine can also be done through the Aarogya Setu app. If you have the Aarogya Setu app installed on your phone, follow these steps. Open the Aarogya Setu app on your phone, select the COVID tab in the application. Tap on the vaccination option and then click register now. The app will ask you to verify the phone number via OTP. After verifying, people need to enter photo ID proof and more details as mentioned. You will receive a text message with the appointment details after a successful registration. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.